Welcome to The Explainer. Today, we're going to tackle a classic financial puzzle. When you're looking at a bunch of different investment options, and they all have different costs and different payoffs, how in the world do you pick the real winner?
Okay, let's dive right in. Here are our five contenders, projects A through E. You can see in the investment column, that's the cash you need up front to get each one off the ground. And that net present value, or NPV column, that's the total profit we expect each project to make, all calculated in today's money. So the challenge is, which one of these is the best bet?
So here's our game plan. We're going to tackle this in five parts. We'll set up the problem, make a simple choice to start, and then, this is the fun part, we're going to add a real-world twist that changes absolutely everything.
All right, let's kick things off with section one. Five projects, one decision. We're going to start with the simplest possible version of this problem.
Okay, so for round one, let's lay down a couple of ground rules. First, these projects are mutually exclusive. All that means is you can only pick one. If you choose project A, then B, C, D, and E are off the table. And second, just for a moment, let's pretend we're living in a fantasy world where money is no object. You've got an unlimited budget.
So that brings us to section two, the simple choice. With all the money in the world and only one slot to fill, how do we find the most profitable project on paper?
Well, the question gets pretty simple, right? Which one of these projects is just going to create the biggest pile of cash? The key here is to just hunt for the highest net present value. We're not worried about being clever or efficient yet. We just want the biggest raw number.
So as you scan down that NPV column, one number just leaps right off the screen. I mean, the first few projects are fine, they're decent, but one of them is just playing in a totally different league.
And there it is. Our first answer. Project E is the clear winner, with a massive NPV of 180. Sure, it costs the most, but it also delivers the biggest profit. Case closed, right? Well, not so fast.
And that brings us to section three, when money is limited. Because let's be real, in the real world, nobody has unlimited funds. So let's introduce a little complication that changes the entire game, a budget.
And just like that, everything is different. We now have a capital budget of 800. And you probably noticed something pretty important here. We can't even afford Project E anymore, which costs 2,000. Our so-called best project is now completely off the table.
This forces us to ask a way smarter question. It's not just which project is the most profitable anymore. Now it's how can we use our limited 800 to generate the most profit possible? We're shifting our focus from just sheer size to pure efficiency.
Which leads us perfectly into section four, measuring bang for buck. To answer our new, smarter question, we're going to need a new tool. NPV by itself isn't enough anymore. We need to introduce the Profitability Index.
The Profitability Index, or PI, is really just a simple way to measure our bang for the buck. It answers a crucial question. For every single dollar we invest, how much profit do we actually get back? It's all about efficiency.
So let's just walk through a quick example with Project A. You take its NPV of 20, and you divide it by the initial investment of 100. And boom, that gives you a profitability index of 0.20. What that means is, for every dollar you put into Project A, you get 20 cents back in pure profit.
Now, here is where things get really interesting. When we calculate the PI for all five of our projects, the entire ranking gets completely turned on its head. Projects A and B, they shoot to the very top with the highest PI, and our old winner, Project E, it plummets to the very bottom. It's actually the least efficient project of the whole bunch.
Okay, on to our final section, the smartest investment mix. Now that we have our new ranking based on efficiency, we can finally figure out the best way to spend our $800 budget.
The strategy here is really simple. We start with the most efficient projects at the top of our list, and we buy them until we run out of money. So first, we'll take Project A and Project B, our most efficient options. That's 300 spent with 500 left in the bank. Next up is Project C, which costs exactly 500. Well, that's perfect. We'll take it, and that uses up our budget exactly.
And there we have it, our new answer. The best, most optimal portfolio is actually a combination of Projects A, B, and C. Together, they use up our entire $800 budget, and they generate a combined net present value of 140. That is the absolute maximum profit we can squeeze out of our limited funds.
You know, this side-by-side comparison really shows the core lesson here. When you have unlimited funds, yeah, you go for the biggest mountain, which is Project E. But when your resources are limited, you find the most efficient climb. And that's the combination of A, B, and C.
And that really is the key takeaway.
The project with the highest NPV isn't always the best investment. The right tool for the job, whether it's NPV for sheer size or PI for efficiency, it depends entirely on the constraints you're working with.
This is why it's so critical to be clear about what you're actually trying to solve for. Are you trying to find the biggest number? Or are you trying to find the smartest, most efficient use of what you have? Because those are two very different questions, and they lead to two very different answers.
So I'll leave you with this one final thought to chew on. We just saw how a simple budget completely changed the right answer. So what hidden constraints, whether it's your time, your money, or even your energy, what hidden constraints might be quietly changing what the best decision is for you right now?